So this is the H4N Audio Recorder, and it comes in a box like this. You just get it from the TA, and when you open it up, pop open the two latches in the front, and it's going to have different components in it. It has a windscreen for it, tucked in right here, and that just stays in. Normally we won't be using that unless you're out in the field recording something. There's also the H4N itself in a clear box. That has a little latch and opens up, and there's the H4N Audio Recorder. Inside the case at the bottom, there is a small gray mount for this that can screw into here so that when you're shooting with it and recording audio, you can position it where you'd like it. So, but for today, we won't be using that inside the studio. There's also a USB cable for transfer and a power cord in case you're out of batteries. The battery latch on the back is really sensitive, and you actually have to push it down a little bit before sliding it to the right. Otherwise, that can break off the little tab on the end, so we want to just be careful with that. There's a ribbon underneath it, so you just pop that ribbon in case you need to replace the batteries, and just make sure that the ribbon is laying flat down when you place the batteries in, and then you'll be able to get them back out next time. Again, with the latch, when the battery latch goes in, you just push it down and slide it in, and that should lock it into place. Now, the H4N Audio Recorder does have some different buttons on it that we'll be using. The first is this door right here, which hides the SD card. The SD card is inside it normally. We normally leave it in there unless it's in a computer transferring files. That'll be in. You've got your recording level right here, which we'll explain a bit more in a little bit. We also have a menu, and then we have a dial with a push button on it, so you can actually push this dial in to select things. On the opposite side, you have the USB port, you have the power switch, you have headphone volume, and a headphone port that you'll be using. There's also a remote that we have that we can use with these, but you won't be using it today. On the front, there are some basic buttons, largely record and stop, play or pause, skip track and backtrack. And then the input sources between mic, which are these up here, and then input 1 and 2, which are the cable connectors down here, which we'll be using today. Then you also have access to the folders, the files, the speed that it records in, and whether it's a WAV or an MP3. And we'll get into those a little bit later. For your power button, you're going to switch the hold over until it lights up, and then you can let go. And you'll see zoom come up on the screen. So on here, you'll notice that there's a zero counter right now. There's a battery life indicator. Batteries are low right now. It should get us through this, but if you're recording a show, you definitely want to replace the batteries. Also, we have gauges. And so right now, because I hit the record button once, it's blinking. It's not actually recording. It's just letting us look at the audio levels. So you can see the meters are moving right now. We want them peaking between right about the -6 decibels, and right now it's not quite there. But we're also going to plug it into a device, so we don't need to set them right now. If you press record another time, that lights up solid, and it's actually counting the timer because it's actually recording now. If you hit stop, it will advance to the next track. You want to hit record again so that it's blinking and you can see your gauges. When you're ready to record the next track, hit record one more time so that it goes solid and it actually records.